Module 2. In this part we will look into the equations of motions used to model moving objects. Here we will talk a bit of history on how ancient people's concept evolved into what we now consider as models for equations of motions. Aristotle was a Greek philosopher and mathematician during the classical period in ancient Greece 4th BC. He had a different belief about freely falling objects. He believed that heavier objects would fall faster than the lighter ones. Obviously, when we compare two objects like a paper and a rock, we obviously would say that the rock, which is heavier than paper, would fall faster. This idea was widely accepted because it was observable and makes sense to everybody back then. Then, 19 centuries later, here comes Galileo Galilei, who was an Italian astronomer, physicist, and engineer, sometimes described as a polymath. He was also known as the father of modern physics and science. Galileo studied several things that has become a basis of physics and engineering. He studied about concepts about velocity, gravity, inertia, and projectile motion. One important thought that he has contributed is testing through experimentation, which has changed how we do scientific studies. This thought has revolutionized the concept of freely falling bodies. One of his famous experiments was conducted in the Tower of Pisa, built in the 12th century. The height of the tower is 55.86 meters. Here he conducted his famous experiment about freely falling objects. In Galileo's experiment, he used two objects of similar shape but of different mass to fall from the same height at the tower. What happened was that both objects landed on the ground at similar time. This also led to an important discovery of the concept of air resistance, which resolves the earlier concept of objects having different shapes. Air resistance is an important concept because in building things that interacts with nature, you cannot avoid it. The mathematical formulation that tackles the equation of motion that is widely accepted comes at a later time by another person. Sir Isaac Newton was an English mathematician, physicist, astronomer, alchemist, theologian, and natural philosopher. He was widely recognized as one of the greatest mathematicians and physicists. His famous contribution to physics was probably the discovery of gravity or gravitational effects. A famous legend on the discovery of gravity was that he was sitting under an apple tree. An apple fell on his head and had a eureka moment that led to the discovery of gravity. The idea of gravity has huge impact on the understanding on the relationship between masses and how they have this attraction. This led to several understanding on planetary motions and answers why the moon revolves around the earth and the earth revolves around the sun and not the other way around. Now let us look at some terms that we need to familiarize ourselves. The study of motion is called kinematics. It is a Greek word for motion. Motion can be described by three physical quantities: time, displacement, and velocity. Time is of course familiar to all of us. We experience time, and it's simply how long an event or activity takes place. Time is measured in terms of change. Final time minus initial time if we simplify it. Its symbol is simply called t. It is a scalar quantity, which means it has no direction. So that mean time changes the same in all direction. The next concept that describes motion is the distance and displacement. The difference between the two is the nature of what type of physical quantity it is. Distance is the length traveled by the object, and it is a scalar quantity. It has a typical symbol of non-boldface letter x, y, d, s, and other letters. Displacement, on the other hand, describes the location of an object with respect to a reference point. It is a vector quantity, which means having both magnitude and direction. Its symbol is usually a bold letter, a letter with a bat on top. The bar is looks like an arrow on top. Let's say you travel from Iligan to CDO. The total distance can be measured from the starting point, Iligan, to the final point in CDO. The distance would be around 269 kilometers. For the displacement, which is measured from its reference point, which is Iligan, to its final position CDO, it would be around 35 kilometers. The third one is the concept about speed and velocity. Speed tells us how fast a body is moving given the formula distance over time. As you can see, it is using distance, which is a scalar quantity just like speed. Velocity, on the other hand, is a vector quantity of speed. Instead of distance, it uses displacement and the addition of direction. Suppose you have a car moving on a straight road from an initial position x naught at an initial time t naught moving to different position with a final time t final and final position x final. Write the equation for its speed. Speed, as you know, is simply the distance over time. We write it as the change of distance, which is the x final minus x naught over t final minus t naught. Find the average speed and average velocity of car if it takes 5 minutes to cover a 20 kilometer road going towards the west. Recall the equation for speed. Here we assume that the initial position and time starts at 0 then moves towards westward. So it is simply 20 kilometers divided by 5 minutes. This yields 4 kilometers per minute, or around 66 meter per second. Therefore, its average speed is 66.67 meter per second and its average velocity is 66.67 meter per second moving west. Let us look at another physical quantity called acceleration. Acceleration is a vector quantity that describes the change in velocity over change in time. Its unit is described as meter per second square. A symbol of letter A and a formula of V final minus V initial over T final minus T initial. Based on the equation, so if the object speeds up it would generate a positive acceleration and if it slows down it would be negative acceleration. So, if the object moves at constant velocity then its acceleration is zero. Let us derive the first equation of motion. We recall the equation for acceleration and we assume an object starting at t naught zero with an initial speed. We write an equation for its velocity over a ladder time t. Here we have the first equation of motion. Now let us derive the second equation of motion. We recall that displacement can be derived from the equation of velocity. So we can have the equation displacement equals velocity times time. From there, if the velocity is not constant we can use the average velocity, which simply initial velocity plus final velocity divided by 2. Then we can rewrite it into change in x equals the average velocity times time. Here we can substitute the final velocity or simply v from the first equation of motion and doing simply algebra we arrive to the second equation of motion. Deriving the third equation of motion. We begin with the displacement function with average velocity and the first equation of motion formula. Rearranging the first equation of motion as an expression for time t and substituting it to the displacement formula would yield the third equation of motion. Here we summarize the equations of motion. We note that this works for objects moving in constant acceleration. Note that each equation of motion has its set of variables that present or absent that allows us to solve problems based on the given values present. We also note that the fourth equation of motion is simply the displacement equation using the average velocity. For objects moving in the vertical like freely falling bodies we simply replace the acceleration by acceleration due to gravity which has a symbol g. The rest of the parameters like x are changed into y to note that it is in the vertical. Here is the table for the equations of motion for objects moving vertically. Where the value of g is equal to 9.8 meter per second square. The end for now. For questions and comments you may send them to dieslearningstuff@gmail.com. You may review the slide on YouTube at dieslearningstuff. Note, please do not forget to use your school email. Also write your complete name and class section. Thank you for listening and see you next meeting.